Would you like to start a product-based business that gives you the freedom to live anywhere in the world, but you don't have enough cash? I'm going to tell you how you can start a business for just $100. Yes, it's possible. I did it myself, and I'm going to tell you how you can do it too. My name is Adrian Fields, and I'm a digital nomad entrepreneur currently living in Bali. I own a brand called Tibetan Socks, and I sell hand-knit woolen accessories from Nepal. I never thought that I would get into this particular business, but I am an opportunist at heart and I see something that works and I go with it. 4 years ago, I was on the verge of bankruptcy for my first business, which was a high-end womenswear design business, manufacturing in India and selling in America. This was a really intensive wholesale retail business where I needed to be there present, knocking on doors, trying to get my clothing into stores, going to trade shows, things like that. It was not a freedom business. However, as that business failed, I didn't know what I was going to do next in my life. All I knew was that I needed to get back to India and I hoped that inspiration would strike me again. And that is what happened. I went up to the Himalayas in the wintertime and just by chance, I found a pair of hand-knit woolen socks in a small shop. I bought a pair for myself and I didn't take them off for a week. And I just had this epiphany. Wow, this is an amazing product. Maybe I can build a business out of this. What did I do? I bought 20 pairs of those socks. I was so broke that a friend had to loan me $70 just to buy them. I brought them back to America in my suitcase. I registered a domain name. I signed up for Etsy. I created a Shopify store. And within a week, I had my first order. And fast forward a year and a half, I had a purchase order from the Home Shopping Network. And I went from those 20 pairs of socks and a $100 investment to selling thousands of these slipper socks on live TV in America. Now I'm gonna tell you how you can take $100 and turn that into a profitable business. The most important thing is that you just get started with where you are. Don't think that you need to have a ton of money to go out and make 5,000 units of something and have the most beautiful, perfect, polished website. I didn't have any of that. I started with 20 pairs of socks, a really crappy Shopify site that I designed myself with no web skills, and just an Etsy store. I didn't even have good photos. I literally would take the slipper socks and put them up on a nail in my wall and take a picture with my iPhone. That's how basic I started out. But you know what? It didn't matter because I had a unique product and somehow people found me. I guess it was decent SEO. I guess it was the luck of starting 4 years ago when it wasn't necessarily as crowded on Etsy and Shopify and everywhere else, but you can still create something today if you find a niche product that people really want. My first point is just get started and prove your concept. Rather than invest a ton of money into something where you might lose all of it, anybody can invest $100. You want to see that there are real people willing to spend real money on what you have to sell. And once you prove that concept, then you can continue to invest and buy more inventory and continue to improve your website and all of those things. But when you start out, you don't need to start big, start small. The second really important point is that when you're starting and you don't have a lot of money, do everything by yourself. I didn't know much about e-commerce, marketing, product photography, or anything else, but you can bet that 4 years later, I know a lot about all of those things. And the reason is that I continually educated myself throughout the process. Also, I didn't have a budget to hire professional people. And in a sense, that was a blessing in disguise because it forced me to really expand my knowledge and skills. Now, if I hire someone, I really know what the benchmarks for success are. Whereas in my previous business, I used to hire professionals who took my money, promised me the moon, and delivered nothing. When I started this business, I kept all the inventory in my closet. Every time there was an order, I would go and take out that item, package it myself, write a handwritten thank you note to the customer, and then drive to the post office to drop it off myself. I did everything from point A to point Z in this business, but you can bet that that gave me an incredible understanding of the product, the customer, and everything that went into selling a product. This takes me to another point, which is learn the ins and outs of what you're selling. When I started as well, I used to test every single pair of slipper socks myself to make sure that they fit properly, that there was no issues with the quality or the production. And it's really important that you have that hands-on knowledge of what you're selling. These people who are just taking a carton load of stuff from China, who've never seen their product, who've never interacted with it, how are they going to be able to interact with their customers or really sell it when they aren't using it themselves? So get that understanding of your product. And Also, use the feedback that you get from customers as you start to sell to continually improve it. That's a really important point. When I started, I was just starting with a kind of basic product that I sourced directly from a little store. But over the years, I continued to improve upon the production and improve upon the quality to where 4 years later, what we're selling is so way far and beyond what I started with, but it takes time, especially in what I do, which is a handmade product, to get to that level. So be patient and kind of let the process grow organically. As you get more customers and as you get more orders, just make a commitment to yourself that you're going to continually get better in what you're selling. The fourth is, as you realize that you have a successful product that people actually want and you need to increase your inventory, reach out to friends, family, or a Kickstarter campaign to generate that next level of funding that you need to invest in the company. In my case, I had a best friend who believed in me enough to invest $2,000 that allowed me to buy the next 150 units and invest a little bit of money in improving my Shopify website. And again, that's an amount of money that is not crazy. I think a lot of people can come up somehow with $2,000, whether it's getting a loan or however. But again, so you can see, I went from originally a $100 investment to a $2,000 investment and continued to just sell. I remember one morning, I actually woke up and I had a deluge of Shopify notifications on my phone that I had sold $1,500 over the night. And that was from one customer in New Zealand who found me and bought 20 or 30 pairs of my socks to just give to all of her friends in Australia and New Zealand. And that was this aha moment that I had of, wow, this is a real business and I can really do something with this. And after that, I continually invested in my company. Another point that I recommend is actually not getting started with Amazon FBA when you start out. The thing with Amazon is that reviews are everything. And if you don't have a killer product, which you know is not going to get bad reviews, you can be dead in the water really early. I was lucky that for the first year, I was only selling on Shopify and Etsy because that allowed me to really perfect my product in the process. And by the time I started selling on Amazon, which was about a year and a half later, I had a much better product. Nowadays also, it's very, very competitive on Amazon in America, and you really need amazing photographs, amazing bullet points, a really optimized website and page, because when I started 3 years ago, that wasn't the case. Lastly, it's important to realize you're probably not going to go from zero to a million in 1 year. For me, this has taken 4 years of building a business to where I have a six-figure revenue now and that I can live anywhere in the world. But for the first year and a half, this was really my side hustle. And it wasn't until I got my first purchase order from the Home Shopping Network that I was able to really take things to a new level. So be patient. You can't force your business to go any faster than it can. All you can do is put in the hard work every day of just being committed to yourself and to your product to continually getting better. That's it for this video. I really hope it was helpful. You can leave me a comment down below if you have any questions. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel for more digital nomad content, and I'll see you next time.